Another useful chart is the area chart. What we've got here is some destinations that phone calls were made to and months, and we want to be able to compare the totals but also the splits between the various destinations. To set it up, we highlight the area, we go to insert, and you'll see we've got an option here for area, and we'll just click on it. And there are a couple of options. There's the 2D versus the 3D, and you've got these options. For now, we're going to do the stacked version, so I'm going to just click on it, and you'll see it generates a graph that looks something like this. If you're not sure whether this is what you're looking for, good idea is always to switch the rows and columns and just see if it gives a more representative indication. In my opinion, this is not great. I'd rather have the months across the axes. So let's switch back. So now we can see what's happening in January, February, March, and which destination is contributing to these totals. As with all of the charts, you can heavily customize this. Let's maybe go and see if there's anything that we want to use here. So maybe let's turn it into that. Maybe make it look like that. So it looks very nice. If we now right click on one of the series and go format data series, you'll see that the options that exist are pretty standard, similar to the column charts. You'll see we do have a secondary access option here, but if you watch and I click, it's quite a difficult one to read, so we don't recommend that for the area chart. But otherwise, each of the options has the same capabilities, and you can change them. If you are using an area chart, you will notice that if you go to the tab called Layout, the Lines tab is opened up. So when I click on it, you'll see we can either have none, which is no lines, or else we can have things called drop lines. When I click on it, you'll see drop lines just drop a line through the point that refers to the x-axis, and it just makes it easier sometimes to read the graphs. Another useful tip, and this is available to all of the graphs, is at the moment you'll see the x-axis has January, February, March, April, May, June. You may want something like this. Perhaps that relates to quarter one and April becomes quarter two. You'll see I've set it up so I have quarter one, and we assume that those two apply to quarter one as well. If I go to my select data and I edit the horizontal axis, at the moment you'll see it only pulls that line through. If we change it to pull both lines through, let go, you'll immediately see what happens here. Let's just click out of it. What it does is it changes the x-axis and nicely puts it in the middle, so we can actually read the graph as quarter one and the underlying stuff. And you can do many other levels like this. And as mentioned earlier, it doesn't only apply to area charts, but all the other charts as well.